Hello, everybody. How y'all doing? It's me, Super Paul Games, and welcome back to Crusader Kings 2. We're in the middle of two wars. We're fighting a war here in the east to conquer Manzia, because we like all the men. It's because this lady here refused to bend her knee. Not for blowjobs, but to subjugate. We offered her vassalization, but she decided to be a giant douche nozzle, and no. And then we were helping our distant cousin over here, Chieftess Lala, in a holy war against this section for Italy. I think she's trying to form the kingdom of Aquitaine slowly. And as you can see, Italy is in the middle of a giant revolt. These dark areas are revolt areas. How revolting. King Dionysus the Great has created the title Duchy of Hamadan. I kind of thought that happened before. So we're going to send some troops out to help our distant cousin. We do have some adventurer threats to worry about. I think we're going to see if we can raise some... Okay, the Holy Order is busy. We're going to see if we can raise some mercenaries. We'll hire these guys. And these guys. I probably shouldn't have hired them all in the same area. And we're going to move them out. As I listen to festive Christmas tunes. I love this game, but balancing the music in the game is not balanced with the crap. As you've probably noticed in some episodes where it's super low or super loud. I've noticed that Cosma and Julius, our son Julius and our nephew Cosma, are not on the best of terms, says Rex. A situation I hope to remedy with family picnic night. Woo! At night, couldn't bears eat us? You're a downer. So they're going to hang out and have fun. It's like, Dad, I'd love to hang out with my cousin. Julius Cosman and I had the greatest time together. I'm sure they like each other better now. I kind of want to make him a theologian again, but I don't think he can change this until... He could change it. Should he go back to being a theologian? Or maybe he could go to being a scholar? I mean, the family focus isn't bad. Or he could focus on, like, business. Let's see, what would he like to do? Petting thieves converted to the Tengri faith. Oh, I forgot. We want to keep on the family focus because he needs to have a baby. Because right now his heir apparent is young Prince Stupid. That does not bode well for the future of the Empire. We may be the most powerful Empire ever, but we have one potential failing if the Emperor's son and our kid is greedy and angry and content. He's not very good at much of anything. So come on, concubines. Come on, wife. Oops, I didn't mean to... bumped the mouse like that. Where are our armies? Right here. Here are the mercenary armies. These little areas are against us too. They have joined the Italian alliance to defend Italian places. Technically, this is a holy war. Not a crusade, per se. The second Albretian holy war for Aquitaine. Fighting Aquaman. Look, even the Pope is against us. Oh, Pope, but you don't have nothing. You know what? Oh, we can't assassinate him. That would have been hilarious. A bunch of our mercenary troops have died due to attrition. Oh, well. Yeah, get you up in Trent. Let's get you up in Italy. How is the siege going? It's going pretty well so far. It's going to take a little while yet. The Blue Army is Chieftess Lala's army. And some of her allies. Technically, there are allies, too. Who are you, dude? Oh, a few Catholics left. People creating titles. Technically, we could create a lot of those titles, and it would probably be good for us, but the Emperor doesn't care. He's like, that's below me. Are they sieging Rome? Who are you bastards? The army of Alsace? Wait, but Alsace is right up in here, isn't it? Oh, right here. That's where that bitch face is from? Our chancellor was like, I made the caliphate like you more. Good, good, good. The Mukhtarid Caliphate, as I'm sure you all know. You can see it right here in the green. Mostly green. Oh, they extend this way, too. Maybe they won their holy war? Let's go take a look at the caliphate a second. The caliph is attacking... No, they're still fighting it. The Maharaja of Delhi. He's like, I just wanted a nice roast beef sandwich. Mmm, that sounds good. You know what? We're just going to have these guys assault. They're not our armies. If they die and lose, who cares? My emperor, I'm pleased to report. Yes, I know. Everyone converts to Tengri. Wow, these mercenaries suck at assaulting. I'm insulted by how bad you suck at assaulting. Red baby bitch, Abby. Someone is of legal age. Oh, wasn't her? Yeah, her mom was the whore. We married to some dude from, I think, Africa. And then we made him convert to Tengrianism. Hey, let's go find you a husband, girl. You can marry. Come on, let's find somebody that's not related to you. No matrilineal marriages, because there's hardly any other powerful Tengri families. Here, we'll betroth you to this kid. That way you won't end up like a whore like your mom. Or maybe you will, who knows. Another messenger is like, man, I kissed up to the caliphate so good. That's nice. Good job. Come on, new mercenaries, get in here. We're gonna have you all join up, and then we're gonna finish this assault on the castle. My prisoner is Lava's complaining about his cell. Is he? Well, why don't we just execute him? Hilarious. You know what? Emperor Rex is like, I'm feeling merciful. Let's let him out. Oh, we're going to put him under house arrest. By that, it means we bring his corpse to his house and leaves it there. He's dead. All right, let's merge these troops. And, come on. Finish assaulting the castle here, bros. Put some pressure on Italy. You can see there's 6% war score. And 6% of that is, I think, because of what we just took. Yeah, because we're here in Trent. My liege, during my stay in Constantinople, I have found a great philosopher. Shaman Jerolim of Schumann says, I like shoes too. My feet tell me where to go. Remember, our emperor not only is a theologian and a zealot, he's also a lunatic. I have found a great philosopher who's agreed to help me with my studies to enhance culture. Shoe culture? Absolutely! Great, 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 I approve! It's gonna cost 500 gold. Is it for shoes? Yes, of course! Oh, he's insane. So I think that helps our culture tech. Not that we can invest it in anything yet. We don't have enough. I wonder if we should hire more mercenaries. It is costing us a fair amount of money. Ooh, look! Unfortunately, our allies, they're getting a little weaker. They have managed, though, to occupy the capital here of Aegon, which they're going for. Oh, wait a second, though. We'll get to this war in a moment. It looks like we have won the war in the east. She refused to bend her knee, and now she loses her territory. Goodbye. The Carpathian War for this territory is over. We will send our army home. And the guy who gets the territory, he had a claim on it. So we pressed on his behalf, and he loves us. He wasn't even a part of our empire, but we got him into the empire. Who's your heir? Wait, your heir is the husband of the guy who used to own this? Am I wrong? No. So this lady used to own this, and then we took it from her, and now her husband is the heir for both of those. Well, I was going to get her killed off. I was like, get her killed off and then marry our family there to make sure it ends up, you know, our clan. Why are we negative 2% on this war? Ragnar's host war lost control of... Oh, I didn't even realize the host had shown up. 25,000 troops up there being a bunch of douchebags. I still think that is a dumb game mechanic. The ridiculously big armies that show up like that. Alright, we're going to go hire some more mercenaries. Let's make sure I hire and I don't dismiss. It's like the Carpathian Foreign Legion. Forget your troubles by going to murder the enemy. You see, Italy is trying to send an army to fight them. They might actually beat them. I don't know how well-trained these mercenaries are. That or they're going to come back here and attack our allies. So far, though, the war is going pretty good. 28% in favor of us, the true Holy Tengri allies. Chieftess Lala, I keep saying about her, but she started with this one territory here. And she's managed to get these. And she's going to get this one if she's successful in our war. Now look at that. The Italian army grows 14,000 men strong. He's got about 19,000 he can call on. I think his army shrunk. We're getting pretty close here on the cathedral. Come on, get these reinforcements up there. It is so weird to be rich enough where we can just go hire mercenaries. And the nice thing about that is that keeps our vassals happy, is we're not killing their guys. We're going to kill their guys sooner or later, most likely. By sending them into some other big war. We'll see what lunatic emperor does. And sooner or later, we probably ought to have another crusade now that we have a new high priest. It has to be 30 years since the last one. This guy looks like a cartoon character. He's lustful, charitable, content, and zealous. He's a mastermind theologian. Siege of York? Who the fuck is attacking York? Oh, there's a Catholic uprising up there. Oh, it's this one. Oh, okay. I thought Prince Kevin to be a more reasonable man. His request to be allowed to duel his rival was slightly erratic. It's Prince Kevin. Our son. Who is our son's rival? He's got two rivals. He's got a rival which is like a cousin. And then he's got a rival who's a 14-year-old kid. No, son. I'm not going to let you beat up. No. No, you're not gonna... I don't know which one you wanted to duel, but no. We can appoint a new chancellor. I don't know what happened to the other one. I hope the caliph didn't kill him. I would think not. The caliphate really seems to like us. You don't want you to lead troops, and why don't you go kiss up to the caliphate? It's worked. It's kept them as friends with us. Oh, we're about to finish sieging here in the Bishopric of Trento. 33% war score in favor of the Italians. Just the other day, skulking as I do, I caused... We just betrothed her to somebody! We just betrothed her. Remember how we betrothed Rad Baby Bitch to this little kid so she wouldn't be a whore? Guess what? We found her whoring around with this guy who's old enough to be her dad. Scandalous! He's gonna expose them because he's zealous and he's like, Tengri would want the truth. Uh-oh. Oh no. This is one of the things because the Emperor is insane. You have decided to introduce a new law to the good people of the realm, as is your right, as the ruler. Now you have to just decide on its contents. Well, we did the Pants Act before. We could do the Cessation of Violence Act, because remember, we outlawed pants. The Cessation of Violence Act. The new law has been written, and courtiers are even now distributing it to all your vassals. You admire your handiwork. whereas the children of the realm have become desensitized to violence, and whereas the general populace seems to have lost all regard for the sanctity of human life. Remember, we're an empire that kills lots of people. Therefore, I, Emperor Rex of Carpathia, decree that all forms of violence directed at other human beings, unless it's a war that we approve of, including both capital and corporal punishment, as well as the torture of criminals, heathens, and foreigners. These vulnerable social groups are instead to be rehabilitated and eventually released back into society as productive citizens. That's actually a pretty cool law. Way better than this pants law when he outlawed pants. A lot of people in the realm do not like him and are mad at him now. So if we look at this guy, he doesn't like the emperor. He doesn't care about that law? What about you? Oh, he hates the emperor. Because he doesn't like the insane law that was introduced. And he's ambitious, and we destroyed titles. You're hosting a dinner, Emperor Rex, for some local dignitaries when the full moon comes into view. Out of one of the windows, trembling, you excuse yourself and hurry up the stairs to your bedchamber while stripping off your clothes. Maybe that's why he outlawed pants, so he could get off his kilt faster? You're completely naked when the guards find you, crouched on the balcony, howling at the moon. Ow! I'm the Emperor, baby! Emperor Teen Wolf, you are not a teen. Ow! 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 He loses a little bit of prestige for that. But he's still the Emperor, so his prestige is through the roof. We have one at the, we have taken the bishopric there. My emperor, he was saying Nevers of Never Never's Land, has converted the Tengri faith. So nice that there's no longer a Holy Roman Empire. I knew I shouldn't have sieged this area. It's mountainous, so the guys are dying of attrition, but whatever. They're not vassals, they're mercenaries. I'm going to send in the new mercenary army to help with these sieges. We are helping, though. The ones you can see in Trent, 6% for Moran, 6.42% for Trento. We're definitely helping our cousin out. Oh, look at that. All these kings want to set up their sons. Probably they want to marry them to the emperor's daughters. Though I think all his daughters are betrothed already. All right, let's merge these armies. In fact, while we're at it, let's slow things down. How is the rebellion, the revolt here, the Grey, going? That's the civil authority, that's our war. It must be this one. Ooh, the Italian revolt is winning. That's just the lower crown authority, though? Oh. But they're winning. That's why Chiefess Lala is so smart. She waited till Italy was in the middle of a civil war to declare a holy war against them. The most powerful Catholic nation there is. Come on, we want to take this city. I'm not hooking you up. This is here. Look at these kings keep showing up. Hey, what about some more incest marriages? How about you just go away? See, like, these people were trying to take Rome. Remember when we took Rome, like, 100 episodes ago? We were one of the Dicktopolous leaders. I think it was maybe... Who was it? I don't know how far back you had to go. Before Radigan. Wasn't it? Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it was Hermes? Or I think it might have been one of the Dongersons. My Emperor, I'm pleased to report the majority of the population of Breda has converted to the Tengri faith. Awesome. Well, this city here, a bosun, is about to fall too. If you mate there, is that a bosun mate? Hilarious. Not really, but I'm having a good time. Maybe I should hire some more mercenaries and send them to war. So many have died. Go hire some more mercenaries and send them out to die. Oh, some child needs to be educated. It's Ernesto! One of our sons. Apparently whoever was educating him, something happened. So we have our concubine, who's a genius, train him. Come on, why aren't you having any more kids, Rex? These ladies are still old enough to be having children. He hasn't popped out any kids in a while. His wife's getting up there a little bit, but he's still got three concubines. I so do not want Prince Stupid to be the emperor. That is not going to bode well. Oh, we got to appoint a new holy man. How about the high priest? We're going to make the high priest our chief diviner. Have him research cultural tech in Constantinople. And then we need a new teacher for this kid. And that's going to be the end of this episode. Who is that? Oh, that's one of our daughters. Not bad. We won the little war in the east, making it much more our territory. In fact, almost all this area is ruled by Dicktopolous people. Because if you look at the Lords of the Sky, it's a Dicktopolous person. So if we go to, I think, Dynasty View, this will show not the property owned by us, but owned by families. The Dicktopolous clan, people who are related to us in our blood, own all of this. Not bad. Well, everybody, I'll see you all next time when hopefully we'll have some more fun adventures. Take it easy.